after the salah, after we make taslim, you know, we'll pray the next prayer, we'll pray it towards the Kaaba. In their salah, they move. What does that tell you? سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. That's what that means. I heard you and I obey. This is what that means. So are we like this when we hear a sunnah, the Prophet Muhammad, or do we say, I don't know, akhi. This sunnah, it doesn't go with my life right now. هذه السنة يعني لا, you know, لا أرتاح لها بالا. Is that what we say? I don't care about your emotions. Your emotions, leave them aside. Leave those for Dr. Phil. You have any problems? That's psychiatrist, and then they have, you know, Vicodins. They have a lot of pills for that stuff. The emotional problems. We have orders and commandments that we follow. So this sunnah that we have to abide by is the same way we abide, the companions, they abided by the sunnah. When the ayah for the hijab, it came down, it was revealed to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. One of the wives of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, she said, رحم الله نساء الأنصار. When the ayah of the revelation of the hijab came down, she said, خرجنا كأن رؤوسهن الغربان. كأن على رؤوسهن الغربان. Meaning, she said, one of the wives, she said, may Allah have mercy upon the women of the Ansar. And the Ansar were the women of the companions that lived in the Medina. Because this, when the revelation came down, they were in the Prophet Muhammad, he was in the Medina. So she said, may Allah have mercy upon them. As soon as the revelation came down, as soon as the wahi, the words of Allah came down, she said that they came out of their houses, كَأَنَّ عَلَى رُؤُوسِهِنَّ الْغِرْبَانِ, like black crows. You know a crow? You know the black crow? The bird is black. You don't see nothing from it. It's black. All you see is its eyes. If you even see its eyes. That's another dalil that these women have to cover up. That's just, you know, a bonus. Bonus dalil. So we take these adillah, we have to take them seriously. We have to take the hadith seriously. That's why the Sahaba's time, they never used to distinguish whether the sunnah mustahabba and sunnah wajiba or sunnah muakkada. Everything to them was sunnah. Everything. Sunnah muakkada, confirmed. Because they didn't take no chances. Can you take a chance right now? Could you take a couple of days off work? I dare you. Go ahead. And we're not here, akhi, to point at, or make people feel bad. La wallah. It's a reminder for myself. Before it's a reminder to you. Because I'm going to be responsible before the eyes of Allah, before you are going to be responsible. So, try taking a couple days off work. Could you afford that? Do you have enough money where he says, okay, I'll take a week off. It's Ramadan, you know, I'm going to make ibadah and read Quran. Go ahead. No, right? Because you can't afford it. So why do we do this with the sunnahs and the ibadahs? It's okay, it's sunnah, I don't need to do it. One little, it's a sunnah. You get ajr for that sunnah. I'll give you an example. Miswak. Little miswak. It's a sunnah. And I remember when I was in school, I was doing the miswak, and somebody told me, what, excuse me, do you have like a phobia or something? Like, do you have like a sickness or illness or something? Why you keep brushing your teeth with the wood? Subhanallah. So I told her, this is a 7th century toothbrush. Muslims, we had toothbrush 1,400 years ago. This is the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Just a little example. This is just little examples. We're not telling people so, you know, they can go on a miswak, you know, spree. Even though it's good in the sunnah. The sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam should not be taken lightly. And we, as we mentioned, that if we have a disagreement, a difference of opinion, we go back to the sunnah and the words of Allah. And then we should, وَيُسَلِّمُ تَسْلِيمًا, and then we should submit. You show me the dalil for something, أَنَا مَا أَعْلَمُ عَنْ هَذَا الشَّيْءٍ فَأَنَا أَقُولُ لَكْ أَعْطِنِي الدَّلِيلِ. right? I have no knowledge of something, maybe anything. I have no knowledge of something. And you see me do something, like maybe you think it's wrong. So you tell me, give me the proof, akhi. And this is okay. This is what we encourage. هذا المشجع هذا الشيء. وهذا هو العمل الصح. That is what you're supposed to do. You say, give me the dalil. Show me the proof. But when the proof comes, you must follow. عندما يأتي الدليل أسأل الله يجعلنا من الذين يتبعون هذا الدليل. We have to follow this دليل. It's not enough just to say give me the proof and that's it. We must follow it. You have to be ready to follow it. So these sunan قولية فعلية, all these sunnahs that we mentioned, there's different kinds of sunnahs. I'll give you an example. If right now we were in the salah and I told you it was okay to tanfith three times to your left. The Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he teaches us, if you hear waswas, if the shaitan comes to you in prayer, he's whispering to you, and تلفذ يسارا وتنفذ ثلاث مرات. The Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, you should say, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, I seek refuge in Allah, and you should go like this. Don't spit, just blow very hardly, three times, to your left. If I tell you this was a sunnah, some people might say, you crazy. It's a sunnah. Is that going to stop me from telling you it's a sunnah? No, it's a sunnah. You can take it, or you can leave it. But as long as I told you what it was, then the proof has came to you. Some people, if we tell them, akhi, it's okay for you, if you see someone outside, he's praying with his shoes. You tell them, akhi, you can't pray with your shoes. The Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, خَالِفُ الْيَهُودُ وَالنَّصَارَى صَلُّوا فِي نِعَالِكُمْ. He said, you should be not like the Jews and the Christians, you should pray with your shoes on. And another narration, the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, إِذَا أَتَى أَحَدُكُمُ الْمَسْجِدِ فَلْيَنْظُرْ إِلَىٰ نَعْلَيْهِ فَإِنْ يَجِدْ شَيْئًا فَلْيَمْسَحْهُمَا ثُمَّ لِيُصَلِّي بِهِمَا. If some of you come to the masjid, then you look at the bottom of your shoes. If you see something, you should wipe it. And you should go and pray with your shoes. Now if we do this, people say you're crazy. Right now, if we were to pray the rest of these taraweeh prayers, right? Taraweeh prayers, and I take myself to blame. Because maybe I didn't do a good job of explaining to the people how the sunnah of Qiyam al-Layl is. I take the blame for not explaining to the people how regular salah is. But inshallah we will get into that in the classes to come. Salatul Layl and Qiyam al-Layl, it was mentioned that the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam kana min hadihi yusalliha iddat marah wa iddat turuqat. There was like almost six ways, more than six ways that he used to pray the Qiyam al-Layl. He used to pray four, then three. He used to pray eight one time and then one witr. He used to pray six and then five witr. He used to pray two, all the way to eight and then three. He used to pray two, all the way to ten and then three. He used to pray two, all the way to ten and then he would pray one. There's different ways he used to pray these salawat. And the sunnah is right there. It's in those books. When was the last time we, everybody ask himself this question. And this reminding myself too. When was the last time that we picked up book of hadith and we read it? Ask yourself, honestly. You know, bidun mujamala. You know, don't give yourself too much credit. You know? When was the last time? So we must take the sunnah, and this ilm is bahrun la sahila lah. Ilm and knowledge of the deen, of the Quran and Sunnah, is an ocean with no seashore. Ocean with no beach. It's a big ocean. Because I know something, doesn't mean that if someone brings me something else, that's not true. But as long as the hadith is authentic, hadithun sahih, right? Ala wifq ma jaa alayhi as-salaf, meaning they understood the salaf, that are the right spirit, they understood it this way, then that's what we take. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions to us, فَلْيَحْذَرِ الَّذِينَ يُخَالِفُونَ عَنْ أَمْرِهِ أَنْ تُصِيبَهُمْ فِتْنَةً